clip.
Tonight at 11.
Doom!
It's a plan! I'm angry! I'm not a slave! I've broken the conditioning! I'm real, I know the enemy, and if we can have this spirit of normal humanity spread, it's over for the globalist! Break the conditioning now! Excuse me.
This is not the InfoWars Nightly News, where the answer to 1984 is not $19.95, plus shipping and handling, but the answer is to try and understand the double barrel bullcrap, the doublespeak, and the Orwellian wonderland we now find ourselves in. So sit back and relax as I take you through a real alternative look at the news and so-called alternative media alike. Enjoy.
Clips, clips.
Alrighty, YouTube, another one of Kips Clips. Welcome to Not the InfoWars Nightly News, an alternative look at the so-called alternative media. Be a bit sceptical about the sceptics, watch the watchers, so on and so forth. And then when you do take a step back, you can see all the links between the Truffer Industrial Complex, all the circle jerks, and all the people... all the circle jerks, best way to explain it. So before we get into that, I'm going to have a look at the David Icke, Luke Radowski, We Are Change interview they done at New York. Just a random meeting of two lovely people. Oh, and David Icke's got a show on in New York. Buy your ticket. Anyway, so we'll have a look at that. It's been good, actually, because for the first time in a long time, I've had a look at David Icke. Oh, and I've not liked what I've seen. But anyway, before we do that, a quick roundup. A few things that I want to point out in the cabal of the alternative media, but there's no links there, of course. There's no links. But before we do that, I'm going to say hi to everybody in the chat room. Thanks to everybody that joined last week. Hopefully you've all enjoyed it and whatnot. And hopefully a few of yous will be joining again this week. So, give me one little second. There was a lot of people watched last week, which was really nice. So, please feel free. Please feel free to give us a wee shout and share and whatnot to your friends, families and foes. Always worthwhile. So I'll get on with the bullcrap in the evening, one and all. Kendo, how you doing? Sam, Aces Blazing, Kendo, the lunatic, Nimi, in the evening, how you doing, guys? Blazing, how you doing, buddy? Nice to see you in. And Tony was in earlier. Centurion was made in the UK as well. Nimi, Gareth, John, Murth was in as well. In the evening, everybody. So, before I do that, as I said, I'm going to be doing the... Hold on a second. Need to figure out what I'm doing here. There we go, that's more like it. So, before I go in and have a look at the David Icke and Luke Radowski interview, which I'll go over towards, like, after I've went over a few other clips. These are just a few clips from one of the cabals one of the circle jerks that's out there in the so-called alternative media. So first and foremost, Let's have a look at some of the sources, where all this information's coming from, the same sources, the same propagandist pieces that keep popping up in the alternative media, covering the same thing, the same sort of a world slant, so on and so forth. So, D7, let's have a wee look at Dabu 7. Now, as you can see, in synchronicity, in parallel, have a look at one, have a look at the other. Same thing, different accent. Selling you the same bullcrap, but to a different demographic. One of them very much knowingly, Paul Beagley, and God knows what Dabo 7's all about, and we'll have a wee look at that, and the source, and whose stuff is getting parodied, so on and so forth. So, and anybody that has got my Skype, feel free to send me a wee message if the audio is not coming through loud and clear. So hopefully the audio shall be okay. Sorry about this, it's just I've got trying to get used to this new format, but I shall I think I know what I'm doing now. Cheers, Tony. Right, thanks everybody. So that the bull crap is working. Right, so let's get on with the yabba dabba doo bull crap.
Inside of a Russian city that sits inside of the Arctic Circle, posting photos to social media and asking the question, what is turning the river here this mysterious blood red?
Yes, and what are you going to a mysterious blood red? You know, I'm going to completely skip over the obvious thing to sort of say this. It is right up there with the apocalyptic Judeo-Christian propaganda bullcrap that the end of times is coming and Jesus Christ, because this is Armageddon and all that good stuff. Death, destruction, because Jesus is coming back. He's going to take us to the promised land. And I'm just going to see let's see how much he scratches beneath the surface in 2 minutes 47.
Now this is the Daldekan River near the city of Norilsk. And as you can see, it has turned a vivid burgundy type, reddish color. And the people are like, what's causing this? They can't seem to get any...
They can't seem to think, like, this has happened in time immemorial. There's been lots of different things. Things leaked into the rivers, copper mines, is it copper mines or other mines, and all sorts of stuff that is actually kind of reasonably explained. But no, rivers of blood red.
Answers. They reach out to the companies around. They refuse to comment. But this isn't one of the most polluted cities on Earth, built around factories. Mostly belonging to the vast metal companies. There's other companies around. But when they're just dumping all the materials into the waterways, this is an effect of it. Now, one of the workers that works at one of these companies said they refer to this reservoir as the Red Sea.
So it's a chemical dump.
Because of the ore that comes through here changing the color.
Wow, I was pretty spot on with just my initial guess.
Now, a lot of people out there in search of, you know, when they hear these stories of the Blood Rivers, you know, biblical prophecy.
Wow, that's exactly what you're doing, man.
In the connection to it. Now, there's going to be something that causes this. So, regardless of where it's at, when, there has to be an agent causing it. Whether it's an algae bloom.
Whether it's God.
Or, in this instance, coming in contact with ore, anything that may change the color of the water. It's happening across the globe, and it has been. And it really is a sign of the times, showing how polluted some of these waterways are.
Wow.
And if they're that polluted, do you think life is going to thrive there and everything downstream from it? So it really is a sign. And it's not good, because I guarantee you, life is not thriving there, and it's probably fighting to survive if any is there. And this is just one example. We've talked.
So how do you take a naturally occurring or a reasonable thing and still turn it biblical? It's a sign.
About it many times before. Now, just the most recent example here. If you guys see anything like this out there, let
me know with Yahoo. This is the link to it. I don't know, is this some sort of, I don't know, Blogspot. And here is your Dabu sponsored boner pill page. Now, next time there's a story out there that tells you boner pills is giving you cancer or something, this man can no longer reliably report on it. He's compromised in the reporting of boner pills and the like. What's that? Is that a nappy? Authentic nappies? I kid you not, man, this is the Yabba Dabba Doo sponsored. But this is the Dabu, official Dabu boner pill page. And you'll get all your lovely lotions and potions there. And there's your little blue or turquoise pill. Kinda your cheap Viagra. Prophecy alert, man! God's coming. Jesus is on his way.
Are you serious? I'm looking at my son. He has a website out there called the Crusader Journal. There's
the Crusader Journal. Wow. My son. He has a journal out there called Praise the Slaughtering of Thousands of People in the Name of Jesus Christ. Yeah.
There's an article. There it is. The Crusader Journal. He has an article out there. There is a river in Russia that has turned blood red.
Oh, wow. Jesus Christ is calling now.
Are you serious?
Are you serious?
Good to see everybody on Periscope. Great to see you guys. You're looking at a river in Russia that has stunned the people in the city of Norsley.
Bullshit.
As the river has turned blood red. Are you serious? Good morning, good morning. Good to see Ohio.
Right, so there's two sides of the same coin reporting the same biblical bullcrap. It's a sign, man. Even though people with brains can sort of work out what's happening here, man, it's a sign. Paul Beagley, Dabu, rhyming and repeating the same crap. It gets put out there through the religious channels because it points to prophecy coming true and thus creating a lovely narrative for the people who want prophecy to come true. Now, man, this reminds me of when there was a huge move Dabu 7 reported on. Russia. I remember this, man. I made tons of parodies about it. I made tons of parodies of it when he was like, yeah, man, there's a submarine. There's a Russian sub in Sweden, big moves, man. And Russia are mobilizing robots to the Arctic. They get a robot army. When it was like a American, a Russian expert saying that they could could have maybe would have given me lots of money, and we could maybe would have a robot army by the year 2030 or something like that. I'm exaggerating a wee bit, but it was along those lines. And the Russian sub that was in Sweden turned out to be bull crap. But hey, big moves, man. So yes, is there something huge about to happen? Let's think about this.
Well, at this point, you have to ask the question, is something huge about to go down?
What, like huge go down in my ass? What do you mean, man? Down your throat? What's going down? Where? What's huge?
And this comes on the heels of Germany warning its people to prepare to stockpile food, water, medicine, all that stuff for...
Yes, this bit of fear comes hot on the heels of Germany putting some fear into his citizens. Citizens, you better buy shit. The economy's tanking. We're telling you to buy stuff. And let's not look into actually what happened in Germany. Just off the top of my head here, here's some details shooting for the hip. The Ministry of Defense, or the German equivalent or whatever, who puts out the fucking guidelines to its citizens, didn't issue a warning to its citizens. It reverted back to a previous position. I think it was 2011, when they went, right, Cold War's over. Our official stance to our citizens is you don't need to stock up water and stuff anymore. 2011, 5 years ago. So the German government have reverted back to a stance they had 5 years ago. Wow, so boom, is there something really big about to happen? Let's see what else. But in fact, while we're listening to this bullcrap, let's go and look at the source.
For at least 10 days. And then we had the Czech government come out and do the same for its people, telling them to get ready, prepare, have a plan in case of an emergency. We also have Russia conducting a massive drill with 120,000 troops right now.
Now, if you're in Germany and you're wanting to prepare your bug out bag, yeah, I recommend you go to Dabu 7 Boner Pills Direct. When Europe and the shit hits the fan, when the shit hits the fan, my Dabu 7 voice is kicking the shit out of my throat, man. When shit hits the fan, I want boner pills, man. Fuck, what the fuck's a syringe? Insulin? Look, it's actually sort of a light porn and fear. It's actually fear porn fucking pills. Like, there's your porn, right? And where's the fear? Where's the guy in the fucking gas mask and shit? Right, so there's your fear. And roll on your porn. Oh, they're alluding to something. What they're alluding to? A bomb! Fear porn. Man, even Yabba Dabba Doo's official boner pill sponsor page is fear porn. I mean, the absolute essence of, like, sort of a visual fear porn. Oh my god, look, it reminds me of Fallout, and I played that on my PlayStation, man. That was like nuclear apocalypse, man. I need my fucking... And you know what, man? When I played Fallout 7, and I've had some of the fear, and then had some of the porn in my GTA, you know, picking up some hookers in my Grand Theft Auto, man. I need some boner pills, and I... Nothing like... Can I get a D7 boner pill, please? They should do a brand of boner pills, particularly D7s. Right, that's enough about boner pills and the official fear porn page of Yabba Dabba Doo 7. Right, now let's see. Yeah, Zero Hedge, man. Let's not trust the mainstream media, man. They're lying to us. They're keeping Bigfoot from us. They're keeping Loch Ness Monster from us. They're keeping the Illuminati from us. Okay, like, you're zero hedge. Right, and again, don't throw out the baby with the dishwasher. They're all, dishwasher? Fuck, that's a new one. Don't throw out the baby with the dishwasher. Keep them both. anyway, Jim, zero hedge. Some good information, right? But go and scratch your nut as to where this information's coming from and who's putting it there, right? Oh, lovely graphs and stuff, man. It's just like the Google, all nice and simple and stuff, man. But hey, hold on. If you go right down, it's ABC, blah, 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 blah. Hold on, I need to try and do a wee bit of... Okay. ABC Media Limited, right? Too many mooses running loosies about this hoosies. right, zero hedge. Now this is again just a Wikipedia page, so please scratch beneath the surface yourself. But this will give you a bullet point as to don't trust the mainstream media, man. Hey, hold on, rhyme and repeat it for me. Some mainstream media tripe. But I'll do this with my voice. Oh, fuck. I think that guy must fucking go through a barrel load of honey. It's like Alex Jones and all that as well, man. Ugh. Anyway, Zero Hedge is a financial blog. Weird, because it seems to be parodied in the in the alternative media everywhere. Without even anybody, one person questioning, what is Zero Hedge? It just gets rhymed and repeated. Anyway, sorry, I digress. On with the bullcrap. Zero Hedge, financial blog that aggregates news, presents editorial opinions from original and outside sources. The news proportion of the site is written by a group of editors who collectively write under the pseudonym Tyler Durden. Yeah, what could be fucking weird about this shit? Trust Zero Hedge. It's not here to get inside your nut. And, I don't know, can you see where I'm coming from? They can't even put a name. These are the modern day corporations. They lie to you. Whose balls do you kick? Tyler Durden? Fight Club? Fucking bullcrap. Anyway, right, so go and check that out. But anyway, sorry, let's get on with something. Oh no, that's the Rivers of Blood.
In Germany is preparing for troop deployment, as they say, a catastrophic terrorist attack.
No, they're not, you fucking dickweed. You're completely lying, man. There's ministers that are talking that they maybe should consider... Oh, man, you're completely taking it out of context, dick. Fucking... he's not that stupid... Germany aren't preparing for deployment.
Is probable, in that it's more than likely...
Yes, 9 out of 10 cats agree on this webpage I read.
...likely going to happen. Now, the way that this has been put into place...
Now, the way this is put into place is that I sit here and read this article that I hope you don't really even click on and go to, because then my whole kind of illusion is kind of falling apart. And then I kind of rhyme and repeat. Fucking hell, man. Then I try and rhyme and repeat after me. All these stats. Like, I know what's happening, man. But I'm just shooting from the hip to get a 2-3 minute, 6 minute bit of bullcrap that rhymes and repeats in mainstream media, who we should not trust. As open
is that there's been a massive influx of asylum seekers coming to Germany, and
hey, the brown people, right, look at the stats
and other countries. You can look here by the numbers.
Yeah, this graph proves everything. Who cares? The graph is just from this website that I don't even kind of quote or indicate to or question the source of or anything like that. No, don't question anything like that. This is just this graph here that I've pulled up. And if you actually want to see the actual laziness behind my bullcrap, what you'll see that I do here, and hold on, I'll put it in slow motion for you so you can actually just see how lazy this shit is. let's put this in slow-mo. so I'll have to actually do Dabu's voice. Yeah. German troops, Moblaz, something big, maybe, CUDA, 9 out of 10 cats agree, probably, ISIS is real, but America controls them, but they're real jihadists invading your town now. Now look, I've got a Google search for German army or something, and I've got a capture screen over it. Now I'm going to just drag this over to the Zero Hedge page. Hold on, I'll show you. Should keep it mixed it up, but now I'm just going to click and drag it over here. Let's see. I'll just hurry up. I think it'll happen soon. Hold on. What's that, Alex?
It's real!
I know. It's real. Look. Click it and drag the screen over to Zero Hedge and go, Israel! Look at the I've got the documents! I've got the documents that are on Zero Hedge. Who's Zero Hedge? I don't know, man. They're on the interwebs. It's real. It's real.
The number of asylum seekers in 2015 into 2016 has skyrocketed. You've seen all the video.
Yes.
All right. Well, first today is Allison.
Oh, we have first today. Hello, Allison. Sorry there. Sorry, Jeeves.
Well, at this point, you have...
Well, at this point, yeah. Well, at this point, no, you're done. At this point, it's just too easy. look at the graph of doom! Yes, when it reaches this level, it's doom. And it's doom with asylum seeker, brown people in boats, clash of civilizations. The same people that imported the brown people are now spewing out the propaganda to get Mr. Whitey to hate the brown people. And nobody can see through the bullshit. And Yabba Dabba Doo 7 is rhyming and repeating mainstream media shit with his eyes caked full of shit. Anyway, I don't know if that's just boring now, isn't it?
2015 into 2016 has skyrocketed. You've seen all the video footage of the different stuff happening in these countries as these waves are coming through.
Yeah, you've seen video footage of different stuff in countries. Woo! Yeah, I fucking fortune teller told me that once, and you know what? The fortune teller didn't lie.
So what they're saying now...
What they're saying now... Who's they? You're not telling the source. They...
Is that they believe...
They believe... So there's no actual any facts or reports or nothing. It's just somebody rocked up somewhere on the internet, something that I've been sent, and now I'm rhyming and repeating it, and they believe...
A big event's gonna happen.
Yeah, a big event. Yes, they could be talking about the prom next week. They could be talking about the... Oh, Celtic, we're playing Barcelona tonight. I don't know the score. They could be talking about their mother's party. But yeah, no, there could be... 9 out of 10 cats agree. Big event.
Now, the only way that they're able to even get troops in the motion to do something like this is because they've slowly been trying to change things throughout the years.
What? The only way they can get troops... They're mobilizing troops, but the only way they can get troops is because they've changed things.
Now, to be able to use the military within...
Uh-huh.
The borders of the country.
Uh-huh. What country?
Was not allowed. Until.
Oh.
They revised it. To where they stated, the only way that you're going to be allowed to do this is if.
You hop in one leg and cluck like a chicken?
There is a terrorist attack.
Ooh!
Which, this was Article 35. They expanded it in 2012. They said the only way that you're...
Article 35. Right, let's do a wee little... Control F. Put in 35. And there's the exact bit of script that Jabba Dabba Doo 7 is rhyming and repeating. It's that easily done, folks. Take a small section of his shit. Control F. And you'll find it on the link below. Sorry. Article 44, 99, hut, hut, hut.
We're going to be able to allow armed forces to be deployed within the domestic borders of that country is in a response to a terrorist attack of catastrophic proportions. And that is in quotations. Now, you don't have to go back very...
And that is in quotations. I'm not going to tell you who the quote is from or the source or anything. I'm just going to say some quotations. It's in quotations. I've done it even better. Quotations. Right, let's go on there.
Very far to see how they burnt down the Reichstag building. A false flag event to get everything to go their way.
Hitler, 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 Holocaust. How the fuck did they get one of the Nazis? Something big happening because Germany is scaring its population by telling them to stock up in food.
All this coming, you know, right before the anniversary of one of the biggest false flags ever done on this planet, on the people here in the United States. And then also alerts put out in regards to sports venues and other stuff that should be red flags because the same groups.
Which should be red flags because every time the government says duck and cover, we all know we should duck and cover. Anyway, that is enough of that bullshit. Is there something big about to happen? No, Dabu, you're just rhyming and repeating a Zero Hedge fear porn piece, basically. And it was done by a guy called Tyler Durden from Fight Club. What could possibly go wrong? What could possibly go wrong? But anyway, yeah. Oh, God, man, thank God, let's move on to something else. this is something I wanted to bring up. This is weird. The No Agenda Show. Oh, shit. 10 minutes. But just talking about all the biblical stuff and all that, man. And I found this absolutely weird as well.
Rather, we're risking getting kicked off. And right in the middle of that, she had one of these fits and she had to go back into toward the front.
Let's stop for a second about this green goo.
Yeah.
You saw this, right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Right? And I said, right.
Right?
So,
yeah, right.
So now there's a couple of things. Either it's, it didn't look like phlegm. I mean, that was just too much. I think she just spit whatever was in her mouth that she was probably choking on. Some substance that became green.
I think lozenge may be a adequate explanation.
However,
she definitely spit it out.
However, I will say, Revelation 16:13, and I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. So two more to come.
Now, they're obviously taking the piss, right? But I just thought it was kind of, I was listening to them and like fucking next thing I know I'm getting prophecy for the Bible fucking said to me. And that is like genuine prophecy and stuff, and it's talking about the green stuff coming out of Hillary Clinton's mouth and they're relating it to frogs and shit. It's funny. But I just thought it was weird coming from the No Agenda Show. And I do listen and watch, and I'd recommend anybody with a critical thinking mind, check them guys out, they're quite funny and a lot of... What a good information, man, but obviously think about them critically, because they don't talk a lot about Israel and stuff, but that's just my opinion. Anyway, so what have we got now? Dundabu, let's do a bit of AJ. Oh, yes. Oh, do you know what else I wanted to... let's have a wee look.
Right now, on...
there's a few...
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show on this...
Oh, sorry, there's a few wee circles we can join here, thank God. What was I going to say? Completely forgot. But anyway, all right, let's get on with a few of these clips. Sorry, this is what I was going to do. If this works. Look. I seen that Ry Dawson has popped up, and he looks like he's doing a wee, what's it called, space cook coast to coast. It's kind of like, what do you call it? Can't even remember. Not the InfoWars Nightly News. It looks like kind of a spoof on the alternative media. Whether that's going to be a format for a show or whatnot, I don't know. But anyway, time will tell. And it's very cleverly done, man. It looks pretty cool. So go and check that out as well. I'll be watching that and keeping them. But a lot of people don't like Ry Dawson and stuff. But anyway, each to their own. Let's have a wee look at Alex Jones.
It's real!
Yep, it's
you. On Infowars.com. MSNBC reporter annoyed at Clinton for lying about her health. We've all been trying to fact-check conspiracy theories. Well, isn't that funny? The conspiracy theorists are right again. When are the people at Infowars.com going...
When are you retards going to stop calling yourself conspiracy theorists? When it was kind of invented as a derogatory term. I use it myself, but I try and caveat as much as I can and stay away from it. But anyway... Sorry, young lamb chops.
To get an apology from all the people that called us conspiracy theories, when now we are clearly vindicated once again.
Clearly we are vindicated. Ooh, vote for Trump. Oh, shit, sorry.
Health. We've all been trying to fact funny. The conspiracy theorists are right again. When are the people at Infowars.com going to...
My sweaty ball syndrome only kicks in when InfoWars comes on, man. It fucking gets you.
Get an apology from all the people that called us conspiracy theories when now we are clearly vindicated once again about Hillary Clinton's failing health and medical issues. But more importantly,
then vote for Trump.
I think what we're seeing here is an opportunity to separate real media from fake or biased media trying to cover up for Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, fake or biased media that covers up for Hillary Clinton, unlike us who cover up for the crimes of Israel while selling you tangy tangerine and a vote for Trump placard. Beware of the two team paradigm, vote for the red team. Beware of the two paradigm, bullcrap, bullcrap, bullcrap. Vote for the red team, buy a gun, vote for the red team and buy my vitamin pill.
Any real media, any respected journalist is talking about this right now, is trying to figure out what is going on with Hillary.
Any real media, any real journalist is trying to get Trump elected right now by parroting pish about Hillary Clinton. If you don't do that, you're not real.
It's real.
Oh, sorry, it is real.
Hillary Clinton's health. If Kim Kardashian, if Justin Bieber, if LeBron James would have fainted and had to have been dragged into a...
What about...
Jim Mars?
No!
Van, it would be all anyone is talking about. Andrea Mitchell from MSNBC.
Who?
Hey, baby, you got a nice rack.
You calm down there, Alex. You leave her alone.
Says that this was so...
What?
You dumb son of a bitch!
Oh, sorry, man. Sorry.
Botched. This was so...
I know you're looking clean and mean, Alex, man. You've been fucking working out in the tangy tangerine.
So mishandled. Well, yeah, I would suggest that dragging around a candidate who's not medically fit to be campaigning and then lying about it is probably not the best way for the Clinton campaign to go about this. For more on the story, Infowars.com.
For more on this story, Infowars.com, where we will hyperlink to our own stuff that hyperlinks to our own stuff and occasionally hyperlinks to Breitbart or the Drudge Report. Yeah! That's all they are!
Clean, pure drinking water.
Yeah! Clean, pure drinking water. Just as nature intended. Out of tin fucking filter.
can't survive without it. But where?
Yeah, you can't survive without it. And Alex Papure? Fuck me, man. This guy's actually got his fucking name stamped on this shit now. Fuck me, man. Wow. I've been out the fucking purified water filter circuit for ages. Man, my knowledge on water filters is just crumbled since I've started watching InfoWars.
You get it. Alexa Pure Pro is a brand new groundbreaking gravity-fed water filtration system that is like no other. The Alexa Pure Pro transforms water from virtually any fresh source into clean, healthy drinking.
Transforms water from actually any fresh source. Yes, so it's fresh in the first place. Yes, put it through a fucking mechanical shit anyway. Yeah! Everyone's a winner, baby. The Alexa filter.
Drinking water, pairing the unprecedented super filtration power of a...
Super filtration power of the filter for... The filter made for ultimate destruction.
All new gravity block core.
With that black and gravity block core. I mean core.
The hydrochromatic shell.
Hydrochromatic shell. Everybody needs a hydrochromatic shell.
It removes up to 99.999% of it.
Yes. And any Illuminatis out there will notice that was 66.666 upside down.
Impurities, including bacteria.
Including bacteria. Yes, all the good yes, and what we'll also sell you is we'll sell you this pill. All the natural bacteria your gut needs for a... So, drink your water. Don't get nothing from nature. And then take our pills with all the shit that you don't get from nature because we... And remember, distilled water is even better. Rips out your guts from inside. Look at Santos Bonacci, the picture of health.
Viruses, fluoride, disinfectants, volatile or...
Fluoride, but not all types of fluoride, only some types of fluoride. Don't leave the fucking phone open.
Organic contaminants and hormones. Filter...
And hormones.
Capacity up to 5,000 gallons. Stainless steel construction. Easy assembly. Low maintenance. Replace...
Oh, look at the hips on that, baby. Woo!
Filters are simple to install, and now, as part of an exclusive limited time...
Guys, we need to fucking sign up now, it's exclusive! Quick! I'm ready. I'm so ready, I've fucking lost my moose loose about this house.
Introductory offer. You can save $20 off the
$20? I can save $20?
Retail price and get free shipping.
Only if I buy it today though, I think.
This is a limited time offer.
Oh, I told you! I knew it! Only if I buy it today.
To order your unit today and receive free shipping and $20 off. Go to InfoWarsStore.com or call 888-253-3139.
Now, why wouldn't I believe this guy when he rocks up and tells me fucking never to drink tap water and fucking, stay away from water? Me thinks this guy's got a conflict of interest. He's actually got his name stamped in fucking... Used to be the Berkey water filters, now it's the Alexa Pro with the concave fucking gold-plated fucking dome. Cock fucking filter. Cock ring filter, yeah! Anyway, shit, sorry man, I wanted to listen to some Alex Jones adverts for obvious reasons. Now, the wrath of God, Hillary collapse. Now let's see how these people approach this.
Live from the InfoWars.com news studios.
When is Alex Jones
and Magadoo?
You know, it's weird, man. For ages, a lot of people have been saying it sounds like Kev Baker speaks like he's getting his teeth sometimes. Alex Jones has got the same kind of similar wee bit of lisp. Do you think it's maybe something you develop when you've sucked too much fucking Illuminati cock?
Yes, I've been containing a Cheshire.
Yes!
Cat grin all day long. My dad, we were out at the lake with the kids when this news came in. Leanne was texting me, so was Biggs.
It's real!
I went and saw the video, and I went, yeah! Yeah! I was just like,
just literally just in ecstasy. And my dad said, that is horrible, celebrating over that sick woman, even though I hate her too. And I went, no, this is a death.
Was anybody in ecstasy? I need to say I was laughing. I was laughing, but I wasn't going, yay. So what the fuck is so funny?
Devastating victory against the enemy and more of the avalanche of them being discredited, and the hand of God is upon this.
Yes.
And it's only...
The hand of God is upon this. Ooh. Yes. Let me just refer to my God manual.
They're going
to
get better the more good people take... Take action. That's why evil always fears us and does everything they can to try to contain us throughout history and suppress us because they're scared of us. Look at these hunchback demons. They're nothing. Sweep them aside once we wake people up. It's not like we're offering some utopia like they do, but we're offering good old common sense prosperity. Can people handle it? Leanne McAdoo.
I'm a hunchback demon, man.
Joe Biggs. Joe, Secret Service. We told everybody a month ago. Exactly what's happening. It's all come out exactly as we said. Leanne, where is this going?
Well, I gotta say, at first, like you, I was overcome with excitement and joy when I first saw it because, you know, it was almost like she was overcome with all the energy of those spirits of the people there at the time.
Yes, goblins came down and spat greeners in her ears until she couldn't function anymore and went, I mean, come on, fuck. If one thing you can see, these clowns want to keep your head in the clouds, right? Hold on, let's get to the bit where he starts buying everybody chicken. Yes! Buy your vitamin pills!
Al-Qaeda and ISIS.
And she couldn't, yeah, it was like...
She struck down.
Yeah, it's
it
like...
It was karma.
Send back the campaign contributions from Saudi Arabia now that we have the 28 pages. You know, she was like overcome. It was like the spirits were there. So I was really rejoicing, but then I kind of felt sorry for her after I saw her.
Dirty Saudis, we all know they done 9/11.
She was really weak and pathetic.
Well, it shows how pathetic evil is.
I don't think I ever felt sorry once yesterday. Yesterday brought an entire new meaning to Sunday Funday. I'm telling you.
Yeah! Oh, I'm sorry.
It was Patriots football day.
I'm going to be honest. 9/11. It was like one long you-know-what yesterday.
It was 9/11 anniversary. It was the anniversary of Benghazi. And Hillary Clinton collapsed so fast. And there's so many
things. I didn't think of that. That seems epic. It's biblical.
It's karma. Yeah.
It's epic. It's biblical. Hee-haw, hee-haw. Hold on, actually. Oh, man, I've got a good one if I can. It's biblical, motherfuckers. Fat lady ever stop singing? Oh,
it is the ultimate thing, and the Patriots won. My buddy's with Donald Trump right now.
Yeah, go football!
Now in Baltimore, and he's actually talking to Tom Brady about sick Hillary right now, from what my buddy's telling me right now. So there's definitely a conversation going on about it. Yesterday was the most epic day ever. I could not stop grinning. I broke out the beer, I made some chicken wings, got a pizza. Watch football.
We're celebrating. I'm getting the crew chicken right now.
I was on my laptop.
Yeah, I'm getting the crew chicken right now.
All day looking into the stuff, you know, watching.
You know, that's it. I only got chicken for this crew. I want to send somebody else. Get chicken for the whole office. Fried chicken for everybody.
Yeah, I only got chicken for this crew. That one guy sitting behind the camera. Right, get it for the whole office. Fuck it. I'll eat it all. We got the good fried chicken, motherfuckers.
We don't get the MSG chicken. We get the good, you know, organic.
Lucy.
Little Leanne and Margaret to eat.
I'm just joking. Anyways, very, very excited.
But think about this.
Yesterday, celery.
Yesterday was an interesting day. The way the whole story progressed, it started off as she had like heat exhaustion. It was 76 degrees outside.
Right.
So if she becomes president, who's going to be president when it gets hotter than 76 degrees outside?
Can't go anywhere worse.
She's the ice queen.
Then the story switched to.
Now, I don't know about you. I don't intend to see how long that goes on for. Bringing you the truth. Like fucking vultures in a corpse, dirty bastards, man. Yeah, break out the chicken. Bring out the chicken. Give me a feckin' break, man. Anyway, let me figure out where my mouse is. That's enough of that. I don't need to be hitting that. Oh, this is a good... I touched on that. There's AJ. Now, let's have a wee look at this.
Tuesday, September 13th. This is day number 284 since Hillary Clinton has had a real press conference, and I'm not counting the non...
Now, let's remember, this guy is the guy who believes in gods and demons are coming here by the Illuminati, demon goblins. he gives these fucking morons the power that fucking somehow they lord over some people because they stand up there and go, they've got magical powers, man, they can stomach demons. I seen the evil in his eyes, man. Should he just wasn't holding in a fart? No, I could see the evil spirits coming in and out this man. Okay.
That's about the sycophant. Small group of people that are allowed to ride on the plane. We talk about having leverage over the press. It's like, what'd she do if they ask her a bad question? She kick them out without a parachute?
What does Alex Jones do when an employee asks a bad question? Put a bullet in his head or just sack him because there's a confidentiality clause no one can talk about without getting sued out, without getting the arse sued off them. Alright, Beardy, who can fucking play that game, you wee snake oil salesman, gimp boy?
I want to talk in this segment that we got. Leanne McAdoo is going to be joining me in the next segment.
McAdoo, do, shake a pineapple, have a tree.
I want to talk in this segment.
To the left, to the right.
About,
by an ER-15. There's a song in there.
Christine Lagarde with the IMF. And her comments today about globalization. You see, they can't ignore the fact that you see what's going on. And they can't ignore, just as Tim Kaine.
Wow, man. This guy's looking into the camera speaking to me. He's saying that I know what's going on. Hey, I'm all of a sudden a fan of InfoWars. What, do you want to sell me something? Of course! How could I not trust somebody that looked into my eye and told me, I know that you know that I know that you know. Now buy my stuff, because I've made you feel good. Saying pretty much ambiguous bullcrap about big fat hairy goblins and Illuminati spiders.
Called out Alex Jones today. They can't ignore the fact that Alex Jones and Breitbart and of course Drudge are...
Ding! hold on. Alex Jones, Drudge... And Breitbart. Stupid mouse. Right, there you go. And the cock train is complete yet again.
Getting the information to the public. We know, all of you know, that it's not...
We know, you know, that I'm gonna come down there. I'm gonna... Oh shit, that was said their previous life is fucking WWF bullcrap. Right, Right. Oh, right, aye, sorry, even the point caller was, it was a Zero Hedge. They're repeating a Zero Hedge fund that's a spin on a release by Lagarde from the International Money Fund herself. So you can go straight to the source and read that shit, and it was a speech, and aye, so there was, again, nothing really there. Look at, I wonder if that's real. I think it is, actually. I don't know, though. Don't quote me on that. He's got the documents! right, so what did I do there? That was what, AJ? Ah, should I do even Mark Dice? Can I be asked doing this, dickhead? Paul Joseph Watson and NBR Change. Right, I'll just do Mark Dice. I'll leave.
Have a look at this commercial for a September 11th sale at a mattress store in San Antonio, Texas, which I will link up their Facebook page in the description below so you can go over there and let them know what you think. Not only are they having a sale for September 11th, where they...
Oh, no. Sorry. This isn't the Mark Dice clip I wanted. That's right. I definitely wanted to touch on Mark Dice, actually, because... let's see Mark Dice and where this guy started off from. Oh, what's this? What's this you're saying, Mark Dice? What's this? I'm trying to figure out if the bottom bit will clear away so yous can read it. It's an obvious no. This bit here, and hopefully yous can read it. Classic Mark Dice from 2007. 2007. Seems a long time ago, doesn't it? Wonder what else Mark Dice was doing. And around. Oh shit, hold on. Oh. Okay. Wrong hole! anyway, sorry. Ah, fuck it. I just need to do a wee bit of jiggery pokery to get this up. I've done this a few times and I need to move that up the top, that's what I need to do. This is what else Mark Dice was doing. Well, this was published in August 9th, 2008, and this was the book on dating strategies every guy should know. Now, you can interpret this many ways, that this man is a very charlatan-like vulture that is pretty much the beginning of his career out of whatever college he dragged himself through. Launched himself as a, I will say anything in a book, charlatan. And pretty much, no principles that I will stick to. I will morph into a big, fat, hairy Illuminati expert because I've read a Jim Mars book or something like that. But in the meantime, now I'll morph myself into someone who slags everybody for worshipping celebrity while I worship celebrity and keep everybody's attention focused on the world of celebrity. And also buy my book, How to Con Women Into Your Bed by Mark Dice. Yes, with two celebrity endorsements. Yes, don't worship celebrity, fools, but buy my book that's endorsed by celebrities. This is the retardation, the cognitive dissidence, the honesty of this man. But hey, look, he used a loud speaker.
A bookstore. A great quiet place to just get away from it all. To have a good cup of coffee and read a good book.
This is before he'd sold enough Illuminati books to go to the gym once or twice, and he had big, even bigger, mantids.
It's a little too quiet in here, I think.
Attention, Barnes & Noble customers. We have a fantastic sale on September 11th.
Now, you will notice how small time that actually goes on. He says this is from 2007. This guy is nothing more than PR stunts and bullcrap. Anyway, and remember, by his book, after he slags people for worshipping celebrity, read the celebrity endorsements on his book, How to Con Women Into Your Bed. Anyway, I think that's enough of that bullcrap. What do you think, Alex? Definitely enough.
Bitch!
Oh, sorry, man.
You know what it's like, don't you've ruined my life? You know what it's like, you sons of bitches? I'm tired of your crap!
Calm down, mate. There'll still be people that will want to drink your tangy tangerine. Whew.
I'll smash your teeth in, whore.
Whoa. Well, those guns definitely are, Alex. Definitely you will. But in the meantime, I'm going to say hi to everybody in the chat while I'm going to get my wee presentation together. Oh, this is actually quite interesting, actually. Yeah. So, an evening, everybody. Thanks for joining. Hopefully, you're enjoying it. That's been my wee roundup of sort of the cabal. Going to join a few other wee dots here as well. We're talking with Ike and Radowski into the second hour, but thanks for joining, everybody. If you do appreciate the InfoWars nightly news, feel free to stick a wee thumbs up. It is much appreciated. You can share it with a friend, family or a foe, and all the links down below if you want to get the event pages. The community page has got about 2,500 people on it. now, so feel free to go over there if you want to share any and all information with similar-minded people. And in the evening, everybody in the chat, Alan, how you doing? Was that White Cat Nine Lives? I thought it was going to be White Cat Lives Matter. I don't know. In the evening, Tony, Alan, Blazing, Colin, Colin, and Nimi, Sir Air Byro, how you doing? Stone Man, how you doing, buddy? Stewie and White Cat in the evening, one and all. Hopefully, I've not missed out too many of these. Thanks everybody that has got involved. MSN99, Colin Gibb, the Lunatic, Stewie, Alan McVicker in the evening, buddy. The artist formerly known as Tony, Heather, how you doing? Kendo in the evening, one and all. Aces, thanks for joining everybody. So again, feel free to stick a wee thumbs up, it is much appreciated. Now I'm going to take a quick, let me see what I'm going to do here. Right, there we go. Before we pop on and continue, I'm going to take a quick wee music break. Allow me to go and air my balls out. And this evening, how long is this? Nah, it's not long enough. I was going to say the fuck that meditation. But we'll do that another time. Religion and politics, not done that in a while. Cracking tune. Or I feel like I've not done it in a while, so enjoy this, folks.
Your fucking dirty bastards, all the lies you tell. Your fucking dirty bastards, man, you rot in hell. Your fucking dirty bastards, all the wars
sorry to YouTube. Welcome back. hopefully you enjoyed that. I know I did. Link is below for Daisy's tune Fear Porn. I'll take you to his YouTube channel. Thus, all these songs that he's got up there. All the ones I play and more. So please go and check it out, man. It's a must. It's shit hot. So thanks for these for the tune. Right, so I want to touch on, we are changing and getting at the David Icke interview, right? This is going to be quite funny, I think. Anyway, let's see. Sorry, I'm still getting a wee bit of the cold. So, this was a video. Thank God it kind of stores the name, which is quite good. So here is We Are Change. And this is We Are Change book trailer, which get put up on their YouTube and then get took down for whatever rhyme or reason, I don't really know. But I did actually, I think I did manage to go and find it. And I believe this is the same one. It still managed to stay up there in the YouTubes and whatnot. And let me play this. And yay! Come on, let's have a wee listen to this.
Mrs. Clinton, will you support the victims' families' call for a new investigation of 9/11?
Queen Hillary. Hey, Queen Hillary. Where are you on the Walmart board? Hey, you can't grab me. Get your hands off me.
Right. Right, look at this. Just, it's saying the things that go through your head but you're scared to say out loud in case people go, but look at the stuff he done, man. Right, so how the hell does he get into hotel room corridors with like Clinton and all the people he did over time? Right, I remember there was one, him and Abby Martin, before Abby Martin got launched in RT. Funnily enough, before Abby Martin launched in RT, she turned up with that Luke Radowski doing a wee stunt in this place in some capital
house. Get your hands off me. Get your hands off me. Get your hands off me.
You gotta go. Get your hands
off. We started as a New York youth group, man. Yeah. Sounds really cool, man. Yeah, New York youth group. Quickly became the call genuine grassroots groups came widely popular and exploded everywhere. It's as easy as that on the interwebs.
An inside job.
And for a bit of context or something that maybe like too long to explain just now, go and watch the video I done about the 9/11 anniversary. And try and get it in context of where a lot of this media might be coming from, knowingly or not.
How dare you?
Why hasn't the government helped the ill rescue workers, the first responders who gave their lives on 9/11, sir?
Do you feel that you did a good job in covering up the...
Yes, again, all these people that the career started at 9/11 truth. Yeah. It seemed to spark an industry.
The truth about 9/11? Dr. Telekow, are you willing to answer any questions at all by the victims' family members?
The second plane is at the second tower. America is under attack.
9/11 was an inside job! Talk about that, Bush! You deported torture!
Come on, I got you all on camera, I hope you know that.
Workers yelling, do not let me down.
You're a criminal! War criminal!
Wow, man, yet again, right in...
Dick Cheney! Thank you, Mr. Cheney. What'd you do on the underground?
Hey, Dick Cheney, how you doing, man? Hey, nice to meet you, I'm Kips Clips, man. I get to stand next to Dick Cheney every day.
Bunker on 9/11. What do you do to stand on the
way? Let's go, let's go.
Get out of my way.
Don't push it.
I'll push it, pal.
We have done nothing wrong. We have not broken any laws. We mean no harm to you.
I hereby declare this to be an unlawful assembly.
Wow, Congressman. Who gave a rousing... preface title, I love We Are Change. see future leaders. I see future policymakers. Right, now go and read the Doctrine of Common Purpose. Hold on. Let me put this in. Common purpose leading without authority. Let's see if this shit comes up. Leading beyond authority. Sorry. Right, now, no matter who you are, what team you're supporting, or what team's agenda you're pushing, if you're out there and you want to change the world very quickly and stuff like that, you're going to have to break a few eggs. You're going to have to break some rules, even the retarded rules that exist, because the rules exist to kind of stop unwanted change. So, if you go and look into leading beyond authority, seven principles, common purpose beyond authority, right? And then, I don't know, this congresswoman over in America, can you see? I don't know if you can see what I'm trying to point out here. These groups and stuff have came out of nowhere, and it's not that I'm questioning the people they're shouting at. It's not that I'm supporting the people they're shouting at. I'm going, who the fuck are these people that are team-handed out of nowhere, using the interwebs everywhere? It's big mad circle jerk fucking Truffer Industrial Complex. Came out of nowhere. They are the media now. They know that. And where are they marching everybody? Towards revolution. And we are the new leaders and all that. I've said for ages something is changing, and I don't think any one man or woman or whatever can stop it. So it's up to the individuals to educate themselves as to what's happening and stay strong. Otherwise, your loyalties are going to get gobbled up by some other people that have a different agenda. Now, not to mention, the funds that went missing, we're looking at that bullcrap, his education, all that stuff, right? But you just go and check that out yourselves. But there was a lot of bullcrap going on around it and all that as well. but yeah, and I don't know if this audio came across. It was kind of dead loud. Let me see if I can. See what the congresswoman sees when she's speaking to We Are Change. If I can learn to work a computer. That's a bit better.
And so as I look in this room, I see future members of Congress. I see future leaders, policy makers, so that we don't have to beg and ask for anything, but we write.
During the next 40 to 45 minutes, you can tweet me at any time. Just getting rid of the music there, getting it out of the way. Tweet me at Allen Show and email Richie at richieallen.co.uk. It's another one of those muggy, warm, humid afternoons here in the great city. Not a lot of sunshine around, but it's sticky. You know, one of those horrible old city days. Eh?
Cheers, James.
Everybody here is focused on things they shouldn't really be focused on, like the derby. United play City tomorrow, the derby. Massive amounts of time being given over to that on mainstream media, which is tragic, really, of course. You know, there's nothing wrong with a bit of recreation, and there's nothing wrong with a bit of downtime watching football. I like it.
I like watching football, but I'm going to slag everybody off for watching football anyway.
Kent, but it doesn't really matter who wins or who loses. We leave it behind us and we move on. But the obsession with it, especially around this time, is kind of tragic and it's kind of...
Yes, if you watch football any other way, any other way different to me is tragic. It really is tragic, you see, Dr. Trina Turd.
The weekend. I just got off the phone to David Icke, who's incredibly excited about being in New York City, number one, but about being at the Grand Prospect Hall in New York tomorrow, September 10th, on the eve of September the 11th, the 15th anniversary of the attacks on September the 11th. Incredible. Now, I shared on my Facebook page today a really interesting conversation between David and Luke Rutkowski from We Are Change. It's on air.
That had not heard, and the circle jerk is yet again complete. Oh, wow! September the 11th. What a better time for David Icke to turn up in the middle of New York and host fucking Buy My Book crap. Anyway, I don't know, man. Maybe these things are really good. Maybe people go there and it changes their life. I don't really know.
Facebook page. It's on David's YouTube channel. Have a look at it there. Go to theworldwidewakeup.com. If you're in New York City listening to this, either on the podcast or whatever, and you are in time to go and see him, check out theworldwidewakeup.com. He also told me, David, that a lady travelled to the Isle of Wight to...
Oh, yes, they're taking a third. I was told... He also was telling me... Right, come on, Richie, it's your darling. Tell me the truth now. You're a journalist. Surely you're just going to tell me all the information you have. Or are you going to spin in some tabloid-esque bullshit to get you tuned into your show to hear what this lady said about some ghost story in MI5? Yes, one day I was climbing out my window and there was a man, it looked like he was in Batman, walking up the side of my building. I was like, hello. Anyway, but there, I can't tell you any more, you see. I may explode. If I tell you now, I may have to kill you. I have to tell you when you tune into my show after you've listened to my adverts.
See him, to tell him her story. Excuse me, she specifically wanted to meet David to tell him her story. And the story she told him is an amazing, but David believes very credible story of espionage, of working for the security services as a honey trap to get information from people. A story of mass murderers and serial killers. A story of phone hacking. It's absolutely incredible. I can't...
It's incredible, I tell you, you've got to be there, D'Artagnan III.
I can't say too much more, and it isn't incredible in terms of the definition of incredible. It's credible.
It isn't incredible as in the definition of incredible, it's credible. That's got to be the best bit of... Oh, hold on, man. Quit your jibber-jabber. Jabba, I better be able to find this, man. It's got to be sweet. Yes!
Cut out the jibber-jabber. Don't be babbling like a fool. Say what you got to say. That's all. Then shut your dang pie hole.
True story.
Right, hold on. Let's listen to that again.
Excuse me. She specifically wanted to meet David to tell him her story. And the story she told him is an amazing, but David believes very credible story of espionage, of working for the security services as a honey trap to get information from people. A story of mass murderers and serial killers. A story of phone hacking. It's absolutely incredible. I can't say too much more, and it isn't incredible in terms of the definition of incredible. It's credible, really credible, what this woman has told David. And David has encouraged...
Cut out the jibber-jabber. Don't Don't be babbling like a fool. Say what you got to say. That's all. Then shut your dang pie hole.
Quit your jibber jabber, Richie Allen. It's incredible. But no, it's not actually incredible because it's credible because David Icke told me. You know, the man that brought you shape-shifting lizards. But hey, let's forget about that. Give him a pass because one day he made me feel like a lying. A lying? A lion. Was that a Freudian slip?
To come and speak with us on this program. Excuse me. Bit of a frog in my throat. So,
Chapter 9, Biblical 7, the apocalypse is coming. Frogs will come out the fucking devil's spawn's throat. Richie Allen is proof the apocalypse is upon us.
We're going to do that soon when we get in touch with the lady. But really amazing story. So much of what she told David is so relevant to what's going on today in so many areas.
Yeah, that the bucket is so fucking relevant, you really couldn't make this shit up. It's almost like a perfect fucking story, man. Shit, I don't know what kind of accent I went into there. But there's Richie Allen putting David Icke tickets in New York, right? There's the circle jerk complete there. And let's get to the man himself, which is quite funny.
This is Grudowski of WeAreChange.org outside of Ground Zero, and in this video we have a very important message. Paradigms are going to be shifted, and this is going to be one of the most important videos that we release. We are joined by the man, the myth, the legend, the one and only David Icke himself. He's here in New York. He's doing a special show. We're going to be giving out tickets to the show in New York City at the end of this video. But most importantly, before we get into all of that, we had...
Roll up.
A very important conversation last night, especially when it comes to the state of alternative media.
This came hot off the heels of the Max Egan bullcrap, and then I'm David Icke, or is he Kaiser Soze? Look at Kaiser Soze hands.
What is the state of alternative media, David?
Yes, please tell us. I mean, right, now, turn down... Hold on, I'm going to get my camera. Fuck it, let's do this experiment. Because remember, I learned my lesson from David Icke standing in front of the Parliament telling me he's just reporting from the reporting from there. So, let's analyse David Icke like he tells us to analyse everything else. And he tells you to be yourself and, like, don't be afraid of what others think and stuff. And you better believe the bullcrap you get from criticising and even daring to take the pish out of a lot of people's idols and stuff. A lot of people, fucking rubs people up the wrong way.
But I think it's sad the way some of the alternative media has gone. In fact, quite a significant part of it, particularly...
Yeah, particularly toilet paper television. Hundreds of thousands of pounds, TVP, TP for my bunghole TV.
In the United States, because people use this term, alternative media, as if it's like one thing. It's not. It's a vast spectrum of...
It's a spectrum of holograms, of spectrums. Perceptions. And holograms and lizards.
View that goes from almost.
Hey, look, it's Gadget Boy! Go, Gadget Cameras!
It's indistinguishable from the mainstream. Right across to, well, people like me who are challenging and questioning everything, including.
Yeah, I'm challenging and questioning everything so much so. Come buy my book and my show for 12 hours. I will make you feel great about yourself for 12 whole fucking hours. You can go home and have a truth masturbation session and think, you know, that all you have to do is sit and project holograms in different dimensional clockworks of the CERN monster Illuminates, and it will all be better. Instead of paying attention to what the fuck is going on in the world, I'm pointing that out to people. Holograms and fairy dust. Now you see the shape-shifting lizard, now you don't. Now it's an analogy, now it's not. Buy my book.
The official version of reality itself.
Reality itself, yes. Now this is where the DMT shit and crazy people like this meet. It sends people off the cliff, man. And it's not to discount thinking about this shit, but don't think about it too much, because then you, what you do is actually neglect the actual reality that you can fucking feel and touch, because you're too busy fucking thinking about different dimensions that may or may not even be fucking there. Okay. Sorry, Kaiser Soze, continue.
And that's fine. People can work in their particular area of interest, but...
Thank you very much. I'll keep doing that.
The common theme for me that makes it the...
The common theme for me is buy my book and never any real actual solutions.
Alternative media, wherever it is in that spectrum.
And remember, this man's so against the state, he rented out Wembley Arena.
Is that it is questioning, exposing, and challenging the official version
of holograms
of whatever the subject area it's operating in.
That means absolutely nothing. He's just filled about 2.5 minutes saying fuck all.
And what I'm seeing...
Oh, quick, tell me.
Since the emergence of Donald Trump is a regression from that in terms of significant parts of the alternative media, particularly in the United States. The alternative media's basic foundation in relation to politics has been that, in effect, it doesn't matter who you vote for because the same hidden hand gets in. So it doesn't matter if it's Republican or Democrat or Labour or Conservative in Britain.
Oh my God, sorry, I take it all back, I'm right on board. Hold on, should I switch off critical thinking and go ball deep? No, not yet. This guy believes in shapeshifting lizards, or he said at one point he did. Oh no! The shapeshifting lizards just made me accidentally press the mouse where I didn't want to press it.
Or Labour or Conservative in Britain, basically the same. The alternative media's basic foundation in relation to politics has been that, in effect, it doesn't matter who you vote for because the same hidden hand gets in.
Yeah, but then everybody tells you to vote for Trump, your gimps included.
So it doesn't matter if it's Republican or Democrat or Labour or Conservative in Britain, basically the same political class.
Let me do something quickly. Ike Russell Brand. David Icke interview Russell Brand show. Yeah. Well said, Ike. Oh, you and your retard army alike are keeping everybody engrossed in the paradigm that apparently we're all now aware of. Including all your wee gimp army. And now there actually might be a few voices out there calling you a shape-shifting lizard shit. No offence, mean, like, look at Luke Radowski, man. Big Luke Radowski. Anyway, sorry, let's get back to you, actually, what you're saying.
Is in control and thus nothing changes. It's actually deeper than that, the reason nothing changes, but that's fair enough at that level as well. Since the emergence of Donald Trump, suddenly much of that has changed. Suddenly Donald Trump, this vacuous, demagogic man who just comes out with stock phrases about everything without any substance, without any explanation of how these things are going to be brought about. This man who plays on people's fears, on people's prejudices, that somehow this man is going to take on.
Thank you.
What they call the globalists.
Thank you.
And as a result of that, in the narrative has changed in these parts of the alternative media from you can't trust any of.
Now, look at the micro expressions on his face. He looks worried or in pain.
Of them. It's all a rigged system to actually, it is rigged but against Trump in favor of Clinton. And what I see is some areas of.
What I see is someone who gets paid by the hour for saying a lot about nothing.
The alternative media becoming little more than an alternative Fox News, who are pushing this.
Alex Jones, what are you talking about?
Well, Republican candidate in theory, this man promoting himself as the man who's going to make America great again.
David Icke looks like a fish.
And what does that mean, Donald? We never hear that. And so we have moved back.
We have moved back? No, we haven't. Nobody moved away apart from you and your wee retard army.
From the narrative that made the alternative media different, which is it's not the person you.
Remember, alternative media isn't one, it's many. We have moved back from what the alternative. Fucking speak for yourself, fucking fish lips.
Should be looking at. It's the system. It's the system that says. In almost every country, not least America, that there are two parties, sometimes three, but usually two, that have any chance of forming a government.
And what's the solution? Understanding that we need to manifest new holograms in our back garden, outer arsehole?
So you vote for party A and they get into government and you don't.
Yes, and remember, this is all good stuff. He must be taking us somewhere of merit. Like an idea of how to withdraw our consent.
Don't like what they do. So to get party A out, you vote for party B, and they get into government. Then you don't like what they do because they're just a continuation of what party A did. But
gang signs or Kaiser Soze.
To get party B out, you've got to go back and vote for party A, and so you have this.
So you have this kind of conversation that's went on for 4 minutes now, and he's went round in circle and circle and circle.
Bang, 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 about change between two masks on the same face. But what has changed in this Trump era, from the moment he started to basically run for the Republican nomination.
Take him out.
Is that that's been forgotten, and suddenly Trump is different. And he's actually, in many ways, dictated the.
I would love. Oh shit, does anybody monitor David Icke better than I do? Did David Icke say any bad word against Trump up until this point?
The way that these parts of the alternative media are reporting things. You know, when he started coming out and saying he was going to build a wall to keep immigrants out and he was going to ban all Muslims and all this, I noticed very clearly that when there were terrorist attacks, say in Europe, what the alternative media have become well known for and brilliant at is dissecting the official story of the terrorist event. To show us, actually, it's
yes, there's free Tucker and stuff, right? Well, this is before it's news. I think this is a Christian. What the fuck? Yes, What the fuck happened here, man? Fuck you. I don't know if it's going to happen again. David Icke breaks silence, talks Trump, rigged elections, and the unseen puppet masters. Yes. Go away, man. Infected me. David Icke talks Trump. Interview part 2. Where's the date on this? Was this March? March of this year. So that's when apparently he started talking about Trump. Whether he was in favour or not, I wouldn't like to comment as of yet.
A manufactured problem reaction solution to justify more police state and more and more control and surveillance. But what I'm seeing now since this Trump period began.
Well, what are you saying now? Because you've been saying this for 6 minutes now and you've not said anything.
Is that a lot of that's gone out the window. Now, terrorist events are not being dissected in the way they were before by this particular area of the Islamic media anyway. They're being used as a means to bash Muslims and to cast all Muslims with the actions of a few. And it's quite not disturbing, but I find it very unpleasant to see videos from alternative researchers talking about the hate of Islam and the way it's a hate religion. And they're delivering those videos with absolute hatred in their eyes and in their face.
Are they talking about Alex Jones?
And what I'm sure many people who've kind of followed the alternative media, I'm sure many of them are a bit confused about what's going on.
Nope. I get shit quite clear in my head. And you're part of, undeniably part of the...
It's not the way anything's going to change. Because what they're doing is becoming that which they've claimed to be exposing. They're becoming the polarity. They're becoming the means for divide and rule instead of bringing people together. And this situation has actually come about most demonstrably since Trump came on the scene. And the idea that he is someone who is not part of the establishment, I mean, please. You become a billionaire in real estate and casino.
The idea that David Icke isn't part of the establishment, I mean, please. An ex-professional football player, Kaiser Soze, brought to you on the BBC, launched his career, his weirdo tracksuit career on the BBC, on the Terry Wogan show. Terry Wogan was an Irish guy who was educated in a Jesuit university. I mean, please.
Kaiser Soze.
Ah, you fucking hobo.
Very clear now, obvious from even emails, is not part of the establishment. I mean, please. You become a billionaire in real estate and...
You become a millionaire in the Isle of Wight.
And casinos and all these things without being part of the...
Wembley Arena shows in New York City.
Establishment.
You're part of the system.
You depend on the banking system to do what you do and you know...
You depend on the banking system to do what you do, yeah? Man in the mirror, oh yeah!
Not part of the establishment. You interact all your life with these pillars of this hidden hand in all...
The BBC, professional football.
...its forms, and you're not part of the establishment.
You're not part of the establishment. This is maybe that's why he looks so scared. Look at his... I think he looks like he's a shape-shifting lizard. He does look a bit lizard-like. Maybe he is actually forming into, manifesting into what he's actually... Maybe it is real.
I mean, here's a question.
Here's a politician's tactic. Let's ask questions.
It's very clear now, obvious from even emails, that the Democratic hierarchy stitched up the nomination for Hillary Clinton and made sure that Bernie Sanders was not going to get it. Do we really believe that if the Republican establishment, despite the rhetoric of a few people, didn't want Trump, that he would have gone through that entire process and...
Yeah, because Alex Jones and Mick Ruffalo told me.
And come out as the nomination. I mean, it's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous. Or is this the established alternative media trying to save themselves because they, because they're supporting Trump?
Those two people...
And people are calling them out. I mean, let's go and look in We Are Change. Right, let's see, I guarantee we can see pro-Trump propaganda on this guy's page. Right, let's read between the lines. Let's scratch beneath the circus. See what the We Are Change have been putting out of late. Let's see what their content has been. Let's see if it's seems to be a kind of a narrative towards a particular, maybe, party. Obama, right? Everybody can slag Obama and just, oh, Clinton. Conspiracy, Clinton campaign, the media telling you the big, right, okay, there's, going to be exposing Trump soon, I know it, there's Ike selling his tickets, Burning Man, yeah, that's the, look, medical marijuana, very predict, Clinton, yeah, Hillary Clinton. Yeah, this isn't politically charged. No. We exposed everybody fairly. And I'm not supporting Clinton. But these ball bags are fucking using applied psychology to get everybody to march and line up between who they want. Look at how biased their pages are. They're doing exactly what the mainstream media does. And it's not that they're telling lies, they're just pumping out narratives without injecting rounded arguments, well, without even trying to attempt to do it. It's just pumping out all the anti-Hillary pish, which is good for Trump. Because the more traffic that all gets. Anyway, I digress. So anyway, there we go. But hey, the paradigm shifting.
Were chosen to run against each other before the whole process started. So how does that square with Donald Trump being this man on the white horse? Who's coming in to challenge the establishment?
David Icke doing this, reaching millions of people for all this time, and where is he taking people? How does that square with somebody who's trying to challenge people's reality and holograms?
How does it?
He sold plenty of books. He's travelled the world.
Some square with Donald Trump talking about Edward Snowden.
He's drove a good few people crazy.
In terms of, not only is he a bad man for revealing the...
How many people do you think have been genuinely locked up by saying that they believe in shape-shifting lizards?
Yeah, man, I've seen a YouTube video. The guy's eyes was flickering.
These things that the public need to know about surveillance and the NSA. But words to the effect of, and basically execution is still legal. This is a man who's challenging the establishment. His foreign policy for quote ISIS is
his idea to find yourself is turn into a tiger.
Is to baby, what was his words, basically bomb the shit out of him. This is a man that parts of the alternative media are pushing for president on the basis that
this is the man that some people out there believe that is the head of the alternative media when he just keeps people's heads firmly up their farter.
This is going to be transformative and stop the expansion of this world, new world order, global state. It's ridiculous. And why it's happening, there's probably many reasons for it, but it's it borders, for me, it borders on the embarrassing for the alternative media.
It's embarrassing, but it also has a way of showing people who really is in the game, because this regression, as you called it, like we've been talking about last night, is massive.
Yeah, it does show you who's in the game. It does. Right now, yeah, a lot of people are getting showed up who's in the game. And this little piece, not only to punt tickets, is kind of an attempt at damage control. We look Radowski looking strangely like Donald Duck there for some reason, but anyway.
It's expansive. We went from people saying the system is rigged, don't vote for the lesser of two evils, to say...
You went from, give me money, donate, 9/11's an inside job, now I'm going to get a university education, with all my super rig out and stuff. Hey bitches, thanks for the education. By the system, I purport to hate.
Saying, well, let's trust the system. Well, he's a little bit less evil. Let's put all of our faith and energy into this. And that media power, the media is one of the most important tools. And we are finally coming up underneath the ashes. We are finally coming up and actually making a significant difference. But a large portion of us have regressed back into the old paradigm of divide and conquer. And it's not only with the establishment, it's not only with the system. It also has to do with race, with Black Lives Matter versus White Lives Matter. It has to do with sex, with feminists versus men's rights. It also has to do with religion, with Muslims versus Christians and Catholics. This divide, which is being pushed on all of us, is dividing and conquering all of the people. Meanwhile, the very people who control everything on the top, they're just laughing. And the people who were fighting it originally, they're playing into it. Yeah. And it's like, what the hell? We were getting so far. We're making such a significant difference in this world with that alternative media. But if you can, David, talk about the kind of a larger infighting that's happening, because we don't want infighting. We want to bring humanity together.
Yes. Don't ever question us or fight within the cult. We shall be one. Kumbaya. Don't question where Luke Radowski's coming from, because he just said on a YouTube channel that we're all in it together, man.
Because all of us here on this world together, we could create a better, amazing place, but it's up to all of us to put our differences aside.
Yes, put our differences aside, just insert your dick here, man.
Understand each other and move forward, and that's not happening. And with the power of media, with more biased information, with more kind of propaganda, which ultimately information is, which you select and choose, we're going in an opposite direction. Talk about the problem of this huge divide and conquer.
Oh, David Icke, you've lost them.
Are happening all over the internet right now.
Well, the thing is, the number of people in full knowledge of what they're doing in terms of pushing the world into this global fascist dictatorship, as this global police state where the less than 1% dictate to everyone else and the police state hold that status quo, which is what I call the Hunger Games Society. The people...
is what I call the Hunger Games Society. Name of my new book.
People that are actually in knowledge and full knowledge of what they're doing is so small.
Yes, it's only me that knows what's going on. And I know about shape-shifting reptiles. And I'm going to try and stand up here with a straight face after trying to claim that. I mean, I'm sorry, anybody that says that shit. In hindsight, and the more I grow, it's been that.
They have to divide and conquer and play on.
Yes, they have to divide and conquer, which means it's kind of implying that I am a big fat hairy Illuminati spider, because I'm dividing and conquering people, because I'm calling these people bullcrap artists?
Off against each other, the target population. I mean, one way of doing that, for instance, is to put some of the target population in uniform to keep the target, rest of the target population in place, dictated by the laws of the less than 1% ultimately. But when you look around society, you see all these fault lines that are there waiting to be exploited. As you say, religion is a classic, playing religions off against each other, playing races off against each other, playing income brackets off against each other. And the alternative media, in its most effective way and expression, should be realizing that anything that divides is serving that which they say they're challenging.
Doesn't really leave much room for debate in what you said, the alternative media, but it's not a whole thing, it's an individual thing, but we should all stay together and not divide and conquer, because anything that's divide and conquer is serving the system that we all hate, so we should all just sit around and fucking look for the tiger inside ourselves. I mean, if we don't all think the same, we're never going to have love and peace and a utopia on this fucking planet. Here, fucking moron, we're never going to have a fucking utopia, you dickhead. It's people striving for utopias. They get a lot of millions of people fucking dead or suicided because they think a fucking UFO is going to come down and save them. Listen to this clown.
So, to play a part in adding to that division.
Yeah, so to try and take the piss out of me for believing in shape-shifting reptiles. It's just a... I didn't know what was happening.
I mean, people will go into all sorts of bizarreness to try and justify that fucking that turd. Now, come on, let's grow up now. Show me a shape-shifting reptoid and not in a YouTube video.
Not least through black and white and Muslims and non-Muslims and many other things. He's actually doing the very opposite and serving the same force that they've spent all these years.
So, have you got this? You're 14 minutes in, and what pearls of wisdom buys tickets and don't question the truth community or the alternative media, because we all need to be in harmony to defeat the big fat hairy Illuminati unnamed monster spirits. trust David Icke because he's calling out Donald Trump. Yes, so what's your answer then, David? Yes, well, the divisions in the UC, and what you need to do is think about the black and the white and the Muslims and the dark, and then kind of go around in circles a wee bit and then talk about the alternative media being divided itself, and then come back and go, well, what you see is kind of round in circles.
Years saying they were challenging. The alternative is not division, but it's coming together.
Yes, the alternative of questioning some man who believes that the royal family morph into lizards is by joining this cunt's club.
One of the things I really press and
is a utopia, yeah. What could possibly go wrong? It's all these fucking political parties and clowns out there trying to chase some sort of a utopia. It drives every country crazy. It gets hundreds of people killed as well.
And talk about at length in these talks on this world speaking tour is that we have to reevaluate who we are.
And what reality? Listen.
I mean, this may sound like esoteric naval contemplating, but it's not.
It's not honest.
It's fundamental to how we get out of this mess. Not by finding solutions to the problems, but by removing the cause of the problem.
Yeah, we don't need to find solutions, we remove the core, and look how convinced and worried he looks with his facial expression. Remove the core of the problem. And what is the core of this problem, David? What do we need to remove? And how do we remove it?
You know, if the cause of the problem is divide and rule...
But that isn't the cause of the problem, you dick. That's how they control us. That ain't the problem.
Then removing the cause is to come together and to...
Oh, that does sound like some Jedi mind trick motherfucking some fucking come round the campfire shit. When that ain't the problem, what problem are you talking about here, pal? The problem is divide and conquer. No, the problem isn't divide and conquer. They use divide and conquer to control people, you moron. Right, let's get this straight. And I don't think you're so stupid to be fucking... Look at them squeezing the shite out. He's trying to squeeze this... Jedi mind trick out. Nobody will notice. Listen.
See each other in a different light. Now...
All we have to do is come together and suck each other's dicks. And everything will be fairy, fairy land. And I will ride home in a unicorn.
One of the things that I'm, where I'm coming from is...
It's my big palace in the Isle of Wight. Built on people believing this shit and buying my books and coming to my shows. Built on the deaths of 9/11. On the 9/11 anniversary, yeah.
That we need to
Who's to say he isn't an esoteric fucking genius? He's making money off of people's deaths.
Evaluate our self-identity.
Yes! Man in the mirror! Oh yeah! Man, there, like, go to David Icke's thing. He'll teach you everything you can learn in a Michael Jackson song. Oh no! Fucking hell. Sorry.
Jack, human attention. Absolutely in the five senses.
Oh, yes.
The difference in the way those two points of attention... We are different points of attention within an infinite awareness.
Yes.
And mainstream science. That we, in our prime eternal...
Oh, no.
You know, if the cause of...
Yes, he's completely went into hairy fairy land. This is the shit I want to listen to.
The problem is divide and rule. Then...
No, nobody said that's the problem, that's what you said the problem is, and now you're problem, reaction, solution, so you're actually telling us what the problem is, when I don't think that is a problem. I would say, rule, police by consent, you know, the people that would come and club you over the nut when you're out there doing what you want without harming anybody, that's the problem. You know, the people that will fucking throw you in a tin cage when you're doing what you want, that's the problem. Not fucking sitting around trying to decipher your shite, pal.
Removing the cause is to come together and to see each other in a...
It's not come together, yeah, suck my
different
dick.
Light. Now...
Yeah, in a different light. Try and... Just try and buy my shit.
One of the things that I'm... where I'm coming from is that we need to reevaluate our self-identity from...
Michael Jackson song.
Our name, our race, our religion, our income bracket, our life story.
Yes, just forget who you are. Make up a new identity. Why not?
Which I call phantom self.
Yes! Fucking, are you listening to this prick? Yes, make up a phantom self. Become a hairy fairy ghost land that rides on unicorns and big Illuminati hairy spiders. Listen to this fruitcake.
To the realization which this system has sought to keep from us, not least through religion and mainstream science, that we in our prime eternal form...
We in our prime eternal form, which means nothing...
...are simply awareness.
We are simply awareness, which again, means nothing. It means nothing, it just sounds great. We are but one, we are the future, we are but awareness, we are but full of calm, we are all young and dumb and full of calm, we are the... this guy's like a fucking Michael Jackson lyric.
A state of being aware.
Yes, listen to this guy, he says a lot and means nothing. I'm aware, my state of awareness is aware that this guy is aware that he's saying nothing and he's a charlatan.
All these forms and bodies and black and white and all this stuff.
Forget about it! Go and jump out a window! Forget about your body! See all this body shit? Ah, fuck it! Man, be it! Like, what did he say? Be your phantom self. Forget about your body. Fuck it! Live in hairy fairyland. Goblins are real.
Just vehicles for this awareness to...
Fuck it, go and kill yourself. Why not? What's the point? Don't go and change anything. Is this your body? You're just unaware. Oh, man. Oh, no, I'm not really here. I'm just an awareness. Man, your reality is fucking head up my arse land. Ah, thank you, Mr. Ike. Yes, the New World Order ain't gonna take over me now. Nobody can control me that my head is up my fucking arse. Yes.
To experience
goblins and fairies
itself. Thus, in our prime form, we are.
Thus, in our prime form, listen to this guy.
Are all the same awareness.
We are all the same awareness.
Having different experiences. I put it like this, we are.
I put it like this. You're talking pish, pal. That's in layman's terms. Mumbo jumbo, bullcrap that means fuck all, other than, hey man, I'll make you feel good about yourself for a wee hour or two, saying ambiguous mumbo jumbo shit about, we are but one, we are the future, rub your cock, I won't mind.
Different points of attention within an infinite awareness. And that.
Within an infinite awareness, within a big spider web of cosmic space dust. Riding on bands of rainbows made of unicorn shit. Directed by leprechauns and Tinkerbell. I love my phantom self, retarded head up my ass, arse land. Thank you, David Icke.
Point of attention can be the size of a pea, or it can be massive, massively expanded.
Yes, big and small. Wow, almost as trippy as thinking how big is your hand when you're on acid, when your hand's in your pocket. Wow, this man's really expanded my mind. Does a tree make a noise when it falls in the forest and you're not there to listen to it? Ooh, crazy man. I could listen to this shit all night long.
And the difference in the way those two points of attention see the world and see world events and see each other is colossal.
Wow, man. 16 minutes in and he's saying different people have different points of view, man. Fuck me, man. No wonder you can speak for 12 hours fucking straight. You're full of pish, man. Shit.
In the way that the difference is in perception. Now, what this system is seeking to do.
What this system?
Because in the shadows, deep in the shadows.
Deep in the shadows, in the deep, deep shadows. Where are these shadows, Ike? Is this where the goblin lair is? Oh no, don't! My god, sorry. I'm so bad at this.
This is a Grudowski. We are.
From. Our name, our race, our religion, our income bracket, our life story, which I call phantom self, to the realization which this system has sought to keep from us, not least through religion and mainstream science, that we in our prime eternal form are
of a unicorn
awareness, a state of being aware.
Just wearing pants.
All these forms and bodies and black and white and all this stuff are just vehicles for this awareness to.
Okay, give me all your money and I will treat my body to a fucking wheel of a time on you. But it don't matter because we're all just one big hard-on awareness. Deal, Mr. Ike?
Experience itself. Thus, in our prime form, we are all the same awareness, having different experiences. I put it like.
Yes. Human being in a prime form are kinda. Well, men are like competing for females and shit, resources, food. That's kinda what we are in our prime form. Not floating around in clouds going, hey. These people will take your heads into the clouds. Listen to them. Right, now, Jesuits set up to shut down the Masons, to shut down the Reformation, because the Reformation was losing the Catholics' monopoly on information and people's belief in fairy goblins. Fast forward to 2016, a man that believes in fairy goblins, that was brought to you on the BBC by a Jesuit, is now getting your head up your shitter. Think about it, man. This guy...
This, we are different points of attention within an infinite awareness. And that point of attention can be the size of a pea, or it can be massively expanded. And the difference in the way those two points of attention see the world and see world events and see each other is colossal in the way that the difference is in perception. Now, what this system is seeking...
Cut out the jibber-jabber. Don't be babbling like a fool. Say what you got to say. That's all. Then shut your dang pie hole.
True story.
Somebody should have said that to David Icke at the beginning of this interview. They could have done it in 30 seconds.
...keen to do. Because in the shadows, deep in the shadows, they know that this is how it is.
Deep in the shadows, deep, deep shadows, they know the hoody, furry, Illuminati reptoids are shifting. They know that we are all real. They know that we are all but one big blob of consciousness under the cracks of the Illuminati Castle Grayskull complex under the Earth.
They're seeking to focus and hijack human attention.
They're keeping your head up your arse, trying to make people stop questioning all these charlatans that are running around the so-called truth movement, trying to get people to believe in goblins, Loch Ness, Bigfoot, keeping people's attention away from actually shit that actually matters and stuff that's going on, people going, ah, boom, conquering areas of the land, the shifting tides that's going on right now, the creation of the new... power structures going fucking forward, the slave masters arguing over who's going to be the biggest slave master coming up, and these motherfuckers not telling you that the slave masters are having a war. They're going, yes, we're single points of a matchstick and listen to this guy's bullcrap.
Absolutely in the five senses.
Yes, the Chinese five senses.
So the only sense of awareness, the...
Oh no, that's Chinese five space shit.
The only sense of perception, the only sense of anything, is the world of the five senses. And in the world of the five senses, they are their name. They are their income bracket, they are their race, they are their religion.
Who are? Who the fuck are you talking about now? I've lost you.
And everything is apart from everything else.
I can body pop too, David Icke.
Thus,
don't think that'll get you any more ticket sales. Stop throwing up your gang signs, Kaiser Soze.
The point of attention of I am five cents me alone.
And look, isn't that hard? I don't know, man.
The potential for divide and rule is absolutely limitless. And that's why they want us in that state of attention, that state of self-identity.
The potential to get everybody's heads up their shitter so they don't actually know what's going on and go, hey man, peace and love, don't question anybody, man, it's just rocking the boat, man. He told me that I was a tiger, man, and all I had to do is look inside myself, and I was one singularity of awareness, man. Well, stand back and look with the fuck, he's getting the hypnosis they're putting the masses under. Hey man, they're getting everybody to believe in, to put it simple, and keep superstitions.
Once you reevaluate our self-identity,
our as in we are one. We are the one. Listen to this occult talk for this prick.
From I am David Icke, and who does this, that, and the other, to I am infinite awareness, having an experience called David Icke, and all the labels that people give.
Yes. Does that not sound like personality problems? Does that not sound like... Is
See, when you actually think about it, see, like, this is one thing. This is one thing that I'm privileged to running a YouTube channel. You get to see the people that rock up towards this information. And without shitting you, man, a lot of very vulnerable people at very vulnerable points in their life rock up at this information. And unfortunately, some of them rock up to this tit. And unfortunately, what they listen to and go, yeah, man, I don't want to be Craig Houston, man. I want to be Infinite Awareness. Yes, rainbows, fairy cups. And boom, off the cliff. Probably, all, if it wasn't us that done it, we probably know somebody that's happened to that we all love and fucking have seen them going fucking, whoa, cuckoo, batshit crazy. And it affects people's real life. And this guy doesn't know what he's doing.
Themselves, they're all experiences, they're not who we are. Then you
why bother with life at all?
Start to realize that whether you're black or whether you're white, whether you're following this religion or that religion, is irrelevant to the fact that we're all in the end one consciousness. And therefore these positions of division, I'm a Muslim, I'm a Christian, I'm an atheist, are simply states of perception. They're not real, they're states of perception.
I perceive you're full of shite.
And if we can just go beyond the five senses and
yes, he's going beyond the five spices, he's going to jazz it up a bit.
Realize this place is an illusion, and all the labels are illusions.
Ooh, yeah, this is an illusion, holograms. Head up your shitter time, people. So what's that, 18 minutes in? How good has he made you feel? How many circles has he went round? What has he actually touched on of any merit at all? Apart from now that it's illusion, man. Five spices or five senses. And don't hate, divide and conquer. We are but one consciousness.
Illusory and transitory. Then the ability for, say, someone to be divided against a white person against a black person because you're black and I'm white, or otherwise, because racism is not just a white thing, then if you say, well,
hey man, I thought you said we were all one conscious and you're now talking about racism as if it's real when it's not, it's fake, it's man-made and programmed into us. But hey, don't say that, David Icke, when it fits into your barrage of bullshit.
Well, you're just a different point of attention to me.
Point of attention?
And you're experiencing this narrow band of frequency, because that's all it is, in a black body, and I'm experiencing it in a white body, but actually, hey man, we're each other.
Hey man, stick your dick up my ass, man, we're all the same, man.
And we start to see that what we see as
join one big cock train, man. What's not to like, man? Come on, we are but one. Just come on, don't complain. Don't have any differences. Just come and board the cock train, man. Come and assimilate into the Borg.
Firm, immovable differences are just firm, immovable perceptions of self-identity.
I'm very happy you talked about consciousness, because ultimately I think a lot of the problems stem from ego, stem from pride, because we are in an arena, just some people decided to throw bread to appease the people, but to ultimately help the people, you kind of have to say things that they always don't want to hear. And it
yes, like these two are a pair of pricks that will take you nowhere. You might not want to hear it, but I genuinely think it's the truth. Thank you, Luke.
It's been a constant personal battle myself in the independent media sphere. Do I say things to get more clicks? Do I say things to build a bigger audience? Do I say things to go with the crowd? Or do I make people...
You are the crowd.
People actually question reality, stick to the...
Question reality? Why do you want anybody to question reality? Surely you want people to get a grasp on reality. This is the difference between me and you! You keep people's fucking heads up their shit and I won't, you fucking... bad person, you. Everybody can make up their own rap. Anyway, fucking hell, man.
I'm going to start calling it a night. This is going on a wee bit too long. But do another 5 minutes. I'm enjoying this.
The official principles and guidelines that I've always stuck behind and tell people the truth. And it's been hard, especially when it came to Ron Paul. Everyone got on the Ron Paul bandwagon, and I was like, no, it's still...
Were you? Really? Really? And I bet you people can now point me in direction of videos. Maybe I just didn't listen to him hard enough.
Playing politics. It's still playing within the establishment. Same with Gary Johnson. Everyone's, oh my God, the Libertarians are going to have a great year this year. I'm like, no. Watch out for the Koch brothers. Watch out for all the things he's going to be doing. Even Bernie Sanders. People disliked my videos thousands and thousands of times. People unsubscribed. Even with Trump. And I'm like, hey, let's talk about his connection with Henry Kissinger. Let's talk about him torturing, murdering people. And I get a lot of flack from it. But months later, when we're proven right, those people come back. And they're with us more than ever because we never led them astray, because we always stayed principled. But that personal battle, that kind of ego to appease people, prevalent, because ultimately...
This isn't me with the audio, this is...
popularity game with a lot of people who try to gain self-esteem, who try to gain validation by having the most amount of people like them. And when you play that, it's a very dangerous game. How do you deal with it?
Well, what I do is I jerk myself off in full arenas, Wembley Stadium Arena, tens of thousands, I don't know how many, thousands of people watching. I just pull my dick out and go, we are but one. Now watch me as I masturbate. Don't worry, it's all an illusion. It's not really happening. This isn't David Icke. This is the body flesh, David Icke, that's riding the soul of the infinite consciousness. Oh, that is David Icke. It's not me that's masturbating in front of you all. Yous aren't really here. Now just put the money that isn't in your pocket in the jar, in the bowl that isn't really there on your way out. And I'll buy shit that isn't really, it's all holographic, with the money that isn't real that you put into the tub. I love how this shit works.
Philosophy and approach, right from the start.
Holograms! Now give me your money and I'll talk about holograms.
26 years ago has been basically...
26 young years! Go from goblins now to infinite... What the fuck was he saying? What are we? Infinite dots of light? Yes, man. Whoa!
Build it and they will come. Speak your truth. Even though people may not accept that at the time, if it does have validity.
This is on the YouTube clip. It isn't me. I'm not getting hacked by the Illuminati yet. Oh.
Then eventually it will be shown to be so. And people will come towards you rather than you going towards them. We live in a world in which...
This is like, see some of the stuff I'm like, aye.
People are programmed from cradle to grave through peer pressure, parental influence in the early years, through the mainstream media, through the education system.
Through the alternative media.
And all these things.
Mm-hmm, from the very early alternative media, lots of people are very programmed.
And if... people download this version of normal.
Mate, I'm not a fucking computer. If the goblins download the version of the reality that the computer goblins have made up, you shall not compute. Your processor may overheat.
This version of how things are. Fire engine going past, by the way.
I could never have told. I thought that was the mothership.
Then, if you're going towards them...
Taxi for a maniac.
...to appease them so they like you, or so they agree with you, then you're going towards the program.
But I thought we can't divide and conquer. I thought we had to all come together. I mean, this is cognitive dissonance, I don't get it.
If we're going to make a contribution, then it's dismantling the program, dissecting the program, showing it's a program, showing it's not real, it's to keep you in perceptual servitude to a belief system that suits the state. And of course, when you do that...
It's a program, you get that? You're a computer. Don't download stuff.
Then that which is still seeing the program as normal is going to call you mad, it's going to ridicule you, it's going to dismiss you. But if what you say, like I mentioned, it has validity, eventually more and more people will start to see that. And they'll move off what I call this postage stamp consensus.
For so many years now, you didn't try to appease anybody. You didn't try to gather as many people as you could. You spoke your truth no matter...
What are you talking about? For many years, you didn't try and gather as many people as you could.
Come to my Wembley Arena! 10,000, the biggest of our fucking tour ever!
These people can't even hear themselves! No, David Icke walked the lonely path.
Or what it was, no matter how many people were offended by it, no matter how many...
Offended by it? Yes. So offensive it was brought to you by the BBC.
People were mad at you, and you...
Yes, the BBC was so mad at you, they brought you on to sell your book about shape-shifting reptiles.
Been at the brunt of so much hatred against you, but you always stuck to being the truest version of yourself, which is extremely important.
But has he been the truest version of myself? Because earlier on he was talking about being... A different person, wouldn't he? Be the fucking point of... I can't even remember the mumbo-jumbo bullcrap. But you heard him talking about breaking yourself off. Be somebody else. Understand that you're just here in this perception of a body. And
once you give away your power and you make your power, I want more likes. I want more clicks. I want more followers. You're not yourself.
How do you do that? You become them.
Exactly.
You have to... To become them, so they, because people are looking to people to agree with them. So when you're way out off the postage stamp, then people, you're obviously often way away.
I'm glad these guys are actually backing up the right to have way out their points of view, and people won't thumbs me down for having a go at their idols.
From people's perceptions and beliefs. Mm-hmm. So they're going, the guy's fucking mad, that man. And therefore, if you want more clicks...
You believe in shape-shifting reptiles, and then you can't even come out with a straight answer whether you believe in them or not anymore.
Some pats on the back and more kind of...
And you were brought to us by the BBC, who you tell us not to trust, and by a Jesuit, who you never really talk about.
Adulation, then you have to go towards them. Even though you might not want to, you go towards them because adulation and clicks are more important to you than standing in your own power and in your own self. So what you have...
Than standing in the Wembley Arena.
...to do is you have to become them, that which you wish to attract, by saying that which you may...
Now, this is straight out the Jesuit oath. You have to become them. I want you to listen to this, right? This I found really creepy. And, oh man. Hopefully I don't fuck it up there. 23. And look, try and read his face.
So what you have to do is you have to become them, that which you wish to attract, by saying that which you may not believe, to engage with them and them to engage with you. My philosophy...
Did you hear that? Go and listen to that a few times. We are change, important paradigm shift. Go and listen to that. This guy's a fraud. He's even coming out and saying it. He's coming out and basically saying the Jesuit oath that you'll come anything to fucking get inside and usurp them. That's what he's basically saying. Listen to that, man. The guy's no good. Shit, lost my mouse. Where's my mouse?
Philosophy is simple. Speak your truth and whatever happens, happens. Because the alternative of not speaking your truth or speaking your truth is not speaking your truth. And where's that going to take us? If you can program someone to believe...
You just told us that you don't speak your truth sometimes, you do become them, you beat them.
If they have no power and they are little me, their experience every day will be of someone who has no power and is little me. So the downloading of perception.
Downloading of perception? Who the fuck's a cyborg? Why does this guy keep talking about as if I'm a computer?
It takes everything. Because this world is just a holographic, in fact, illusory physical reflection of human perception.
This world is just a big, fat, hairy... Right, so there you go. The guy keeps your head completely up your shitter. Right, sorry, I've actually went on far too long, man. This has went on far too long. But anyway, fuck it, I enjoyed it. So in the evening, everybody, and the people that have stuck about anyway, Stewie's in, Nimi, MSN, Coleman, how he's doing, guys? And I've seen Heather, Martin, Alan McVicker, Stewie, Weed Puffin, Martin as well, how you doing, my man? Daniel Whelan. So in the evening, guys and girls, thanks for joining. Again, if you have Jamesy Boy Blazing, don't know how many's have stuck about, that's half one over here in the UK, so I've probably lost a few people to sleep. But if you have enjoyed the Not the InfoWars Nightly News, the David Icke and We Are Change Luke Rodowski breakdown, feel free to stick a wee thumbs up, it's much appreciated. All the links below as well if you want the event pages, the community page, there's 2,500 people there if you want to go and join that. Daisy's channel for all his music, and my backup channel, so on and so forth. So thanks for joining, everybody. And let me see, I need to get where I am, there we go. Right, so I'm going to play this out with the outro. And join next Tuesday again for another Not the InfoWars Nightly News. And thanks for joining, everybody. Catchies!
Fear upon, come on. It keeps the cheese and the maize and the rats and the race and those peasants in the days like a hell upon the ace. It's a fear upon, come on.